Hey, Mike, how would you describe your short tenure with the Lakers, and what did you discuss in the meeting? How do you think that kind of impacts things moving forward just for your career, generally speaking?
It was up and down for me, but I think I finished pretty strong. So, I don't know. Like we were talking about last night, I wish I played better when I first got here, but I don't know. I'm really grateful for the opportunity that the Lakers gave me. It meant a lot to me, and I just hope to have a nice off season, get some time to kind of recharge, and just go from there.
You came into this team at a time when there was so much upheaval and there were certain awkward situations happening. What was it like to sort of enter that locker room fresh like you did?
It was the first time I've been traded on the trade deadline in my career. So it was an adjustment for me, just, for me personally, and trying to learn all the plays and get to know everybody. But and all I can say is that it was a good learning experience for me. And, it was an interesting 2 months, but like I said, I definitely learned a lot, and that's what I'm most grateful for.
Mike, what were the circumstances in which you learned about Magic's resignation, and what was your reaction? What did you kind of see in the locker room last night?
I was in the locker room getting ready for the game, and then coach, came in before, like we always do, meet at 32 in the clock, and just, kind of address the team about it, and then just said to focus, keep our focus on the game.
What was Luke's message when he talked to you guys about it?
He just said that, it didn't change anything for the game, and that we should just stay focused on that.
Mike, over here to your left.
Oh, hey.
What do you think changed by the time you got here? And, obviously the team was trying to make that playoff push right towards that trade deadline. How would you describe maybe the last 2 months of the season? And what do you think was the difference of being as close as the Lakers were at one point to really distancing and not being in that playoff picture?
And it's hard for me to say. I came in at right at the deadline, so for me, I was just trying to focus on doing my job, and that's kind of where my head was at. So it's hard for me to say.
Mike, what do you think the pitch should be to prospective free agents now that you've been through it? You've come to the Lakers. What should they say to players to get them to want to come to play for the Lakers?
I don't know. It's not my job to give the pitch, so I don't. For me, I really enjoyed the organization here, my teammates. I really enjoyed playing for Coach Walton. He's a really great guy. He knows his stuff. And as a Minnesota boy, the weather was great too.
Mike, back here.
Yeah.
The smiles we saw, the winning ways we saw down the stretch, despite no postseason. Being inside that locker room, why was that?
I think, just kind of having that mindset that we knew there was only a certain amount of games left, and just trying to cherish what we had. And it's a real, it's a bonding experience to be with your teammates out there playing, 82 games in the regular season, and you get close. So I think, at least for me personally, when I think about it, just kind of knowing that, we're still in this, and we're still got each other's backs, and we're just going to go out and do the best we can and try to put on a good show for the fans.
Mike, you played against LeBron in the East for a number of years. I just wondered what in the 2 months you saw from being his teammate and how that compared with some of the other elite players that you had played with previously.
I think the biggest thing I noticed from LeBron this year was, being a teammate of his, which was really cool, was just how observant he is. And that's something that I'll always remember is, you know, he notices so many things on the court, on and off the court. And, you know, even when he wasn't playing these last few games, he would make comments to me, you know, about things he saw out there that I was really impressed by. I mean, just every possession, you know, he knows what's going on with, you know, with our defensive rotations. You know, he's very, very observant, and I thought that was really cool.
I was wondering if anything in particular developed between you and Reggie as two of the guys coming in sort of in that midstream moment, and if you guys leaned on each other at all.
We were actually roommates in the pre-draft process, so it's kind of cool to come back around and play with each other. But you know, we stayed at the same hotel. But other than that, you know, I just it was cool coming back full circle like that, being roommates before the draft.